Well, it's good to be back with you. We have Annie and we have Chip Dodd. And Chip is an author. He's a speaker and a counselor.
All right.
You just help
all right.
a lot.
Good dude.
You're a people helper. That's what you are.
And today he's a dating coach. You're a dating coach today. We're doing it today.
Yes. So we're going to talk about dating today. Okay. So, Chip, when you think about dating, is dating a healthy practice for followers of Jesus? Like, is it?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
What's the good stuff of dating?
With a good, Yeah. We live in a hyper addicted culture. Mm-hmm. In fact, I've got a book coming out called Hope in the Age of Addiction. Mm-hmm. And the publisher picked it up because I'm saying addiction's a pandemic.
Yes.
And I think where it's affecting us more than any other place is in the territory of men and women, in the area of even dating. And I bring that up to say this, that beautiful dating, healthy dating is, and I know it's gonna sound weird, but my youngest son says, this is important, Dad. I don't get to hear this much. Mm-hmm. This matters.
Yeah.
How it's really made to work is that, you know, we're raised in a culture where the guy, his job is to say yes at dating, and the girl's job is to say no when it comes to getting close and dating. You go out, your job's to watch out for him, his job's to try to get you not to watch out for him in terms of boundaries and bodies and touch and care. But if we were a really healthy dating culture, it would look like the following. My job is to say no as a man to you, and your job is to say yes to me. And so his job is to say no to her, because if she gives her heart, she will give herself. She's hungry to give herself completely, which means you better be really, really serious about this woman's heart. Otherwise, because she hungers to be chosen, and if you choose her, then you must dignify her with, this is not just willy-nilly, this is like, I want to be in covenant with you.
Yeah. Mm.
So that's the seriousness of dating. But boys are raised in so many ways to say yes, and the girl has to practice saying no to her own heart. Mm. And so what happens is she's having to fend off the guy from advances, but he's objectifying her. He's treating her as an object instead of as a person. Mm. So she's kind of like, well, can I trust him? And he's all mixed up, and then she gets wounded, and then she sees herself as having been fooled, and he's got a scar against himself for having mistreated this girl by promising that she was more important than she was. And then all of a sudden they have two scarred people. She sort of begins to devalue herself and give up on being chosen. He sort of starts thinking of himself in terms of like nothing really matters, and women aren't the valued human beings that they're created to be. So valuable that I will live my life in service to this other human being. Do you know, that's covenant. And so we live in a culture now that's hyperactive with objectification. Hyperactive from the multiple forms of, we can have contact with each other, but very little connection. We are removed from our own neediness and removed from the sacredness of relationship, the sacred beauty and duty of valuing each other's hearts. Mm. When I chose Sonia, she expected that choice to be her and her alone forever. Like, that's huge.
It's a big choice.
It's a big choice. And I'm going to need a whole lot of other people to help me understand the full value of what it means to love another human being.
So that's a lot of pressure. Like, you think about that choice, right? So people feeling that pressure, what do you say? Like, in the choosing process, or in the process of dating and getting to know, how do you deal with that pressure of like, this is a choice that I'm making for the rest of my life?
Yes, and I think it's so important that pressure, the person who's in that pressure, they need to know their own hearts. They need to have other people in their lives who know their hearts. We as human beings have to be trained and taught how to date, how to value hearts.
Yeah.
Do you know?
Because it feels like there's this extreme in me and my friends that there are times where dating is so casual. Yeah. And it's just like all the time, swipe, swipe, yes, yes, yeah. 4 first dates a week.
Yeah.
And then there's others who are like, I will not go on a date if I don't think that he's the one.
Yeah, and that's...
They're both extremes.
Yeah, extremes, right? of not asking the real question.
And what's like, the real question?
Well, it's like if you're waiting for Mr. Right to show up, that's like waiting for somebody to come ask me to be a model.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's like nobody's gonna come find me. I've gotta put myself out there in life.
Yes, yes.
So, and life happens to us while we're living. The truth is in the middle. Mm-hmm. I mean, look at these two extremes, what's in the middle?
Mm-hmm.
And so being able to talk about and talk with other men and women about what I'm hungry for, what my prayers are, what I'm listening for, and being able to share with each other what we're looking for, being truthful in the midst, vulnerability with boundaries. The two greatest needs of a human being, the need to belong and the need to matter.
Okay.
And I believe that a woman's need to belong and matter is met through being secure.
Mm-hmm.
The security of being cared about, like truly whatever it takes for me to get to take care of you, I will do.
Mm-hmm.
That kind of sacrifice, give. And sacrifice doesn't mean I'm giving up something, it means I'm participating in something sacred.
Mm-hmm.
And so, but a man's need to belong and matter is met primarily through being affirmed. Mm-hmm. Security doesn't matter as much as being affirmed.
Okay.
Like, I'm the one you choose back because I am made like I am, and I will go do what I'm made to go do. I'm talking about how we're made relationally to complement, secure and affirm each other.
Mm-hmm.
Like yesterday, she said something about, I'm on the pastor search committee, and she said, you know, you've given hours, and was telling some other people this, you've contributed hours and done all these things and prayerfully walked through all these things. And I haven't thought about it.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I hadn't put it together, but she watched. A drop of her affirmation literally motivates and encourages me to press on. You know, and it would be great from you, but from her, it's like, you know me.
Right.
Yeah.
We've chosen each other, and so from you, the one I hunger to hear from, it's that much more substantive.
Even in dating, when you start having those touches of, I can tell my affirmation matters, and man, when he just makes me feel secure is such a good word, like not even like he's never gonna go anywhere, because they all have, but you know, I mean, spoiler alert, we're all done. I finished all of them so far.
But you think about
it. But I do feel that like, oh, this is a touch of the right thing, because he's working to make sure I feel safe here.
Yes, and think about, and you joke beautifully, and you have such spirit of life in you, yet think about the courage you have to say, no, I'm not married, and yes, I hunger in my heart to be chosen. That is tremendous vulnerability with boundaries, but what courage to say, I want to be everything God called me to be, and my hope, you say, is that I'll be married, but I suspect married or unmarried, it's you I can't live without, and you're not talking about that person, you're talking about God, because...
That's right.
And Sonia says the same thing. It's God, without you, I can't live.
Mm-hmm.
And same with me.
Yeah, we've talked about before that I think I'll always say that, partly because of the time I've had, that God is the love of my life. I can't wait to have a husband, but the Lord's gonna be the love of my life.
It is a security in the midst of the struggle you walk through.
Mm-hmm.
And successful people are people who struggle well. Married, single, dating, not dating. Old, young, I mean, the capacity to struggle well is the marker of success versus not even living, not really living.
That's it. Just waiting without any living.
So Chip, what does dating look like continue? I mean, does dating continue when you're married?
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
The daily routine I talked about, you know, like the beauty of marriage is the daily life. When we're right in heart, everything's dating.
Mm.
I promise you, Sonia and I were going out to get ferns one day. It's early morning, Saturday, and we'd just gotten coffee, and I said, hey, this is a great date. And she goes, I can't believe, no, I'm serious, this is really a great date. She goes, oh, okay, well, good. Because she was expecting me, like, we're going to get ferns, when can we have a date? But like, everything can become a date when we're tuned in to complimenting and appreciating each other in those those things. So the dating has to continue, otherwise daily life takes over and it becomes just the list instead of remembering what we're doing this list for. So dating makes it, takes us off the list.
Yeah. You know?
That's good.
Thank you, Sheriff.
Thank y'all.
Yeah.